We now welcome our next guest for the day, Mr. Rishiraj Singh, Regional Director, IIEBM. Sir, may I have your permission to begin, please? Thank you, sir. Sir has completed his schoolings from St. Xavier's Schools, Jaipur, and his graduation in economics as major from Ferguson College, Pune. Sir has done many short films as an actor, and one of his short films was been nominated for Oscars. And then he went on to be a part of real estate industries. Currently, sir is a part of fashion industry where he is promoting top designers of the country. With this, I request sir to kindly address the batch.
Good evening.
Can you hear me?
Great. So it's been a long time. Not been here. So yeah, apart from doing a lot of short films, to start with, that I was a part of my debut film 10 years back, and we started in 2007. I auditioned for it. I remember I was shooting for my short film, which went on to be a part of Oscars in live action category. And there was a friend of mine. He became a friend, obviously. He was a senior actor to me, and you know, we met at the shooting in Vai. So this was a UCLA project, University of Southern California. And I went to the shooting location, and I'm there waiting for my room to be allotted, and I got to know that there is no room. And this senior actor, he's an NSD gold medalist, and he's been a part of a lot of films, and his name is Debu. So Debu was very kind enough to, you know, say that, you know, you can stay with me in this room, with his in his room with him for that night, obviously. We worked, we finished our shooting 3-4 days and went back to Bombay, and I was with another friend of mine, you know, listening to his script, and suddenly I get a call, and this guy says, "Tere mein bhook hai, you want to do something really good, can you do this, can you do that?" I said, "You just let me know what needs to be done." And he said that you are meeting to this meeting with this producer and director tomorrow morning. I said, "Fine." We met this gentleman, they saw my working stills from my FTI short film, and eventually, yeah, there was no audition, nothing, and I got the role of my life, I would say that, although the film never got finished. We finished only 80% of the film. And we started shooting in Delhi, and we moved on to Bihar for a 15-day schedule. And when we reached Bihar, we started shooting. So Debu was also a part of this film, and Debu arrived in Bihar. I was the hero of the film, the main lead. And this time my senior actor friend had no room. And that was the greatest opportunity to offer gratitude, to make him stay with me in my room. So that was one of the finest memories I have of, you know, going through something like that in life, where you get offered something and then you have the opportunity to repay the debt of gratitude that one can really do with such really kind people. But unfortunately, we finished 80% of the film, but we could never really finish the complete film. Anyways, life is like that. And but then there are no regrets in life, because I feel that regrets just make you, you know, pull you down and not let you go through what you really need to do in life. So today, basically, I'm going to talk about certain life lessons that I have learned in life, and to tell you that life is not a laddu. That now that you are here does not mean that you have become successful in life, does not mean that you are not going to be successful in life, but means that you are at the right platform in life. You've all gone through a lot of struggle to be here, you know, through your exams, through your interviews, traveling. Some of you must have traveled to a city to give the test. Some of you must have traveled here and gone back and thought over it, whether to join this college or that college. You know, it's a tough choice to make, because you have to start your life. But the reality is that you are at the right platform. Now what you make out of it is your way of doing it and your choice. Whether you think that now I'm a part of MBA college and I'm going to have a job in hand,
I'm sorry, that is not the way it works. You know, so you'll have to work towards your goals. You'll have to choose your way. You'll have to really, really persevere. You'll have to really nurture your own self and really, really work hard to be where you want to be in life. So you have to plan, you have to project yourself, you have to really, really, really put in a lot of hard work. It's not going to be a cakewalk. That is the truth. So starting day one, if you are serious about it, so my uncle used to say that if you want to really enjoy life, work hard today. But if you want to enjoy life today, you'll have to work hard tomorrow. So choice is yours. So I'll start with one of the best life lessons that I have learned is life is like cricket. You know, the rules matter. You can't just say that, you know, it's not the cricket that we play in gully cricket, that where we can cheat and where we can get angry and just walk away. Life is like a game of cricket where rules matter. There are certain amount of overs that you have to play. The best of players get out at one ball also, but does not make them the worst player. They are the best because they can really take that one ball and die down and then bring in somebody who's going to do something better. So they support that second person. They don't say that I'm the best, I'm out, now the game is over. It's a long game. I'm not talking about T20. That's entertainment. I'm talking about serious cricket. So it's a long game. You have to sustain. For sustaining, you have to prepare. You can't get out. Today, I can't say that I'm going to play cricket for 50 overs tomorrow because I will not be able to sustain it. Probably, yes, I may just be standing there and can get over it, but as a player, I won't be able to do that. So you have to prepare, you have to train. Even a Sachin Tendulkar trained like hell. He used to really, really train very hard, not just practicing cricket, but building himself to sustain those standing hours on the field. So it's a very important thing that think of this as a long-term game. Plan accordingly, physically, mentally, you know. So it's important to really work hard. Nobody died of hard work. People die of boredom. People die of sitting idle. So if you're working hard, you are on the right path. Then I would say that nothing happens in cricket and then everything happens. That one wicket, that one sixer, that one boundary just changes the game completely. And that's what keeps us on the edge of the seat. That's why it is such a powerful game, and that's why it's loved by so many people, in, especially in our side of the continent. A great person said that many people think that life is not like a game. Life is like greatest of all games. It is one of the best things that we can do by making it like a game. There is a very beautiful film called Life is Beautiful. And I would request that if we can show this film to every one of you. It's a German film. It's about a boy. I'll just give you the story so you can always, but definitely have a look at it. It's about a boy and a father and a son who are stuck in war. And how this father makes the war a game for his son so that he does not feel that he's amidst a war where he may die, he may lose his father, or his father may lose him. And that film is outstandingly beautiful. So the moment you do not make life into a terrible mountain in front of you, it will be very, very nice. You know, even a mountain can be climbed. Everest is climbed by many people now. Because again, they train hard, they work hard to get there. And the worst part is coming down. You can go up the Everest, but to come down is resistance. It's really, really tough. Life is too short to deal with bad people. Now, you can choose who's bad or who's good for you, or you can just look at everyone as good. That's what I do. I don't see the bad, I just see the good. There's a Japanese proverb which says, a reputation of 1,000 years may be determined by the conduct of 1 hour. So, how you conduct yourself is how you're going to receive from the person in front of you. So, you may say that is a bad person, but you're seeing bad, you're reflecting bad. So, it is very important to just not let things make you stop in life because you think that, okay, I am not able to succeed or I am not able to do things because of this one bad person in my life. Even a bad person teaches you what not to do. So when we have good company, we get to learn that what is to be done. When we have bad company, we get to know what is not to be done. Run it like you own it. Leadership is about responsibility. So when you take responsibility of just not your own self, but your friends alongside, you will be able to really, really nurture yourself and the person next to you. So it's not it's not something that you have to do just for your own self. If you take everyone along, you will reach the goal. The goal is to reach together. There's nobody coming first here, nobody coming last here. Everyone is an equal here. Details and discipline matter. So whatever you're going to get here is anyways going to be in detail. But how you take it in detail or just in points is up to you. So you will get the points, you will have to explain yourself why detail matters, why in terms of planning this particular lecture also, there is a lot of detailing which has gone in. The arrangement, the electricity part of it, the sound part of it. You guys, how are you going to do this? How are you going to, greet the person who comes in? So detailing and discipline matter a lot. By discipline, it is very important that we create a certain decorum in the place where we are studying or where we are working or where we are going to work also. If we don't follow it, then nothing will work. So you have to have a discipline. You can think that I am now a part of an MBA course and I'm just done. But discipline is the most important thing here. Leaders cast long shadows. So those of you who want to be real leaders, you'll have to work very hard to really, really take everyone along. And each one of you, the moment you think that each one of you is a leader, then only you'll see everyone as an equal. But each one of you have to see each other as a leader. You can't just say that I choose this person because this person doesn't know how to speak in English, or this person is coming from a small city or a village or a town. The best of people I've interacted have come from really, really small towns because they work really hard. They don't take things for granted. They don't take things for they really strive to know because there is very limited resource for them. So they make the best of it. So it's important to do that. Don't forget to manage sideways. You're always part of some team. So don't try to manage sideways in the sense that don't try to just make things up and just, ho jayega attitude ya kar lunga main to kar lunga, something like that. You have to take that responsibility as a team. So 19th batch is a team who needs to succeed in every endeavor, taking each and everyone along. Not just your own self, that I am going to do the best and not tell the other person next to me if he needs my help. You have to help each other. Then only you will succeed in life. Think beyond yourself. don't get entangled into your self ego. You know, don't get stuck in life that I am the best and I am going to do the best or I am going to top the college. You know, nothing like that. You top it for your own self, not for anyone else. You have the determination that I will do my best here, I will rank the best here, but I will also help each and everyone around. Look at every moment as a test of your ability and strive earnestly behind the scenes. Working behind the scenes builds one's character and develops one's strength. Again, taking initiatives, working behind the scenes. Now to put this whole show, there are certain people who have really worked behind the scenes who are not, you know, doing it for their own self. They are doing it for you guys. The person standing here, the person taking care of the camera, the person taking care of sound, the person walking us through, the person who's there wanting to make sure that you get to know the best from the best. So it's very, very important that you strive earnestly also in your coming term here to take responsibilities. You will learn the most behind the scenes, where you will not be applauded, where you will be working very hard, where you will be just standing on the door and thinking that why am I standing here? But that is the time, exact time, that you're learning a lot and growing in your life. Don't be busy, be productive. It's not important to be busy throughout the day. I get a lot of people coming to me and saying that, you know, I need to be busy, I need to be busy. Nobody says that I want to be productive. Everyone wants to be just busy. So it's important to be not busy all the time, but be productive all the time. So if you can finish your work in 4 hours, you don't need to be busy after that. But make sure you do the best in those 4 hours and be productive and do that. Either you run the day or the day runs you. These are few of my favorite quotes that I'm quoting here. So either you run the day or the day runs you. So plan your day. Make sure that you know where you're going to be at what time and be there at that time. So plan in a manner that you're going to train yourself every day. You know, you should know where you're going in life. You should know what your targets are. You should know that in this much time I need to accomplish this much at least. So you can't go to a gym and be there for 10 hours and you will come out with a, you know, six-pack body. You will not. So if you're giving 45 minutes there, but if you're doing it with intensity, if you're being really, really productive there, not talking, not chatting, not being on the phone, not doing anything, not checking out Facebook, Instagram, all that, you will be productive then only. Coca-Cola sold only 25 bottles in its first year. So never give up. So it's important to not give up. Even if you think I have failed today, never give up. Stand up again. The process of life is all about standing up. How many times can you stand up and fight back? How many times can you resurrect yourself? So in a boxing ring, there is a count of 10 when you fall down. So the one who gets up gets another chance to be victorious. The one who does not make an effort is gone. Then somebody else is a champion. Decide what you want. Decide what you are prepared to give up to get it. Set your mind on it. Get on with work. So decide what you want. Decide what you are prepared to give up on it. Now that you are here, decide what you want for yourself. Decide what you are going to give up to get what you want here. So you'll have to give up on a lot of things in life to achieve the greater things in life. So we have to really sacrifice a lot to get the best in life now. So decide on that, set your mind on it and get on with work. Target, 2 years you have here, not 4 years, 5 years, nothing like that. So you cannot think that ho jayega, kar lenge, chal jayega, pahunch jayenge. A lot of my impression is that a lot of guys think that this is a grooming place. This is not a grooming place only. If you think that I need to be groomed, then it's a grooming place. If you think that I'm already groomed, then you are just again going against yourself. But there is a lot to learn, there's a lot to understand, lot to figure out as your personality, as everything else, because most of our college life that we do is not a proper day-to-day, you know, disciplined way of doing it. Colleges are there, okay, you go to the college, basically everyone attends the canteen more than the college, in a college. So it's important to be responsible for your own life here. Figure out what you need to give up now, so that you do not think about it tomorrow that I had to give up so much, or I could have given up so much in order to achieve this, because that next person sitting there gave up and is way ahead of me today. One day or day one, it's your decision. So again, coming to that, so one day or day one, you can think and decide, one day I will start, one day I will do it, or day one I will do it. So most of us think of starting a workout or gym or whatever exercises, Monday I will start. So Monday is like one day. But the moment I decide and determine, then it is day one. Now I will do it. So when you do it now, you're on. Otherwise you're just planning. Listen with the intent to understand, not the intent to reply. There'll be many instances where you will be listening to a lot of people, but listen with an intent to understand. Mostly when we listen, is our mind starts working to reply. So we start talking before we start thinking. So it's important to listen and understand and absorb. So when we read a certain thing, there is something, there is a meaning to it and there is an intent to it. So when I say that listen with the intent to understand, the meaning is listen carefully. But the intent here when I'm saying is that you need to really, really be more and more attentive. The intent is that this is the last chance to understand. Take every day as the last day of your life and then see where you will be in life. If you're going to just take it as, you know, tomorrow is another day to understand, then you're losing out on that one day. It's gone. It's better to go slow in the right direction than to go fast in the wrong direction. So careful when you are deciding, when you're wanting to do things, when you're wanting to get ahead in life, be very, very careful. It's good to be slow in the right direction than to be wrong in the fast in the wrong direction. Muhammad Ali, have you heard of Muhammad Ali? Yes, who was he? The greatest boxer of all time, not just the boxer. He said that I am the greatest. I said that even before I knew I was. Muhammad Ali said this about himself, that I am the greatest. I said that even before I knew I was. He was not overconfident. He was very well prepared. He was not a boxer by fluke. He was not an accidental champion. He was prepared to be the best in life, and he knew from day one that I am the greatest. If you have time to whine, then you have time to find solution. Do you understand the meaning of whine? Not W-I-N-E, W-H-I-N-E. So if you have the time to crib, to curse, to say that this is wrong, this is not what I had asked for, this is not the way it has to happen, this is not the way this person should have behaved, this is not the time to do this, maybe not for me, maybe not for the person. If it was or why did I have to see this person in the morning, you know, things like that. If you have time to do all that, then you have the time to find solutions to your problems. So instead of whining, sit down and find solutions. You will find them within yourself. You don't need to go to anyone. The man who asks a question is a fool for a minute. The man who does not ask is a fool for life. So when I said that, you know, ask a lot of questions, this is what I meant. So a man who thinks that, you know, asking a question probably, you know, thinks that I'm a fool for a minute. But the one who does not ask is a fool for life. So ask a lot of questions, make a lot of mistakes. Stand up. Even if you don't know it, just stand up and try. Do that. You are in a professional course now. So it's not about just mugging up books. It's not about just getting through your graduation marks and all that. It's about learning day-to-day life. It's a professional course. It's about administration. It is about putting your belief. It is about putting your strengths, your creativity, your courage at stake. So put all, come all in. Put all your wealth here at stake. But if you have the determination, if you have the inclination to do it, if you want to succeed, if you want to survive, if you want to create a legacy, you'll have to work hard. You'll have to do things which nobody has ever thought of doing. Think out of the box. Think, how can I be a step ahead in life? You have now, the world is right in your palm. You have the gadgets, you have the resources, you have internet, you have all the facilities. Now is the time to make the most of it. So either you can veil away your time looking at pictures of people who do not matter to you, or you can find out how many ways I can really do this. How can I update myself? How can I be, you know, be at the times that we are going through right now, in terms of economy, in terms of politics, in terms, you need to know everything. There's a friend of mine, he's a Supreme Court lawyer. He reads at least 4 newspapers in the morning. He gets up at 6, even if he's sleeping at 1, 2 in the night. He needs to be updated every day, because he works for the one of the finest lawyers, the biggest lawyers of the country. Because his boss can ask anything, anytime, be it economics, be it politics, be it anything. So you need to be very, very well prepared. You need to be very, very advanced with your own self. So whatever has happened is gone. Now is the time to start. Refresh yourself and be ready to go. It was great talking to you guys. If you have any questions, you can ask. I can hear you.
Good evening, sir. Good evening. Name is Shubham Panore. I am from Nagpur. Sir, my question is to you. How would we find our passion, and how would we, how would we recognize what is talent we have? That is my question, sir.
So, can you put the mic down? Keep it on the chair. Leave it. Now try picking it up. Try picking it up. So the gap between finding that answer is this much only. Try it out. I said try, you picked it up. So the moment you start doing things, the moment you start getting at it, as I said, it takes 3 months to figure out what or learn anything. So another very dear friend of ours, he saw his father just getting ready every day at 8 a.m. in the morning and waiting to go to his office. He had no passion, no hobby, nothing. And that drove him to find a hobby. Today he's one of the finest adventure motorcyclists. He's now a person who people look up to in terms of finding out the best gear for a motorcycle, which is the best motorcycle, how to ride it. He did not know nothing about it. So you have to find that in your life. It could be art, it could be craft, it could be anything. You need to find your own USP, unique selling point, that I am the best at this, that or I can be, so you can enhance from here on. So you need to first try out things. It could be acting, it could be talking, it could be singing, it could be listening for that matter. It's a very, very passionate and very, very patient art. You need to have a lot of patience to listen also. So when you want to find out what is your passion, what is your talent, try out first. You'll have many opportunities here to do that. Hope everything is well at Nagpur. It has rained terribly there. Welcome. Anybody else? Are there many?
Good evening, sir. My name is Sarvesham. I am from Jaipur. So my question to you is, to be an actor, like what type of challenge you have faced?
Rejection. 5 times a day.
Sir, and how you prepared for that?
Be happy. If you're grumpy, you're out. I grew up on listening to these stories. I never met my grandfather. He expired in 59. So that's where it started, and school obviously was there, plays, and it went on.
So yeah, sir, there is a drama fest. It's a very interesting.
Yes.
Thank you, sir.
Welcome. Okay, after that.
Sir.
Good evening.
My name is Manish Dayar, and I'm from Agra. So my question is to you is that, how do we know whether the path we have chosen is right or wrong?
Very tough to find. So I did economics majors, I went to become an actor, then I got into real estate, now I'm into fashion. And also talking to you as a regional director of IIBM. So you play many roles in life. Right now is the best role that you're playing. Do your best in this. And you'll get where you need to be. So life is a process. So it's not the end that you are doing MBA and this is the end of life. Okay? People do IIT and then go on to become collectors. Not art collectors, IAS officers. People do engineering and went on to make films. Correct? I know some people who have done BCom and have software companies. They're developing software. So it's a determination that you make and the time that you're in. So you are right now studying here. This is the best role that you have. This is the best choice that you have made. So when I was acting, that was the best thing for me that time. So my heart is still there. I'm not out of it. I have my friends still there. I am, in touch with them. They're producers, writers, actors. All that is there. But then I had a certain role to play that time. I was there for this much time. People I know there who are still sitting on benches and waiting for their character, or waiting for that one role. Two people I know who, one wanted to direct a film before he could get married. So I left Bombay 6 years back. He was 55 then. He should be 61, still not married. Because he could not finish a film as a director. That's stupidity. One man did not marry because he wanted to buy a 3-bedroom apartment. I know them personally. This is being stupid. You play what you're doing right now is the best role you have, the best time you have, the best ability that you can nurture right now is this only and nothing else. Understand? So this is what you need to do right now. Your time will come. You will play different roles. You will be dealing with different kind of people. You will be taking up different kind of, you know, attributes in life. You will be doing things that you never even thought of. But you will come around. You will get there. And enjoy life the best. Be happy, as I said. Don't be grumpy. Don't be sad.
You have the mic?
Sir, can you please share any experience that kept you motivated on the way when you felt low and you want to quit, but there was something that kept you motivated and you go to the end?
So as I said, it was my instinct. So when you know from within where you want to be, and when you know that life is not just about one thing, so the biggest motivating factor that way was my practice of Buddhism, which I've been doing for last 14 years, where I could learn the real aspect of life, where everyone is equal, everyone is facing problems, everyone has to face problems. But then everyone can overcome those problems through believing in oneself, by taking initiatives, by being compassionate, by being courageous, and not giving up on your own self. So times went on and I kept changing my roles, and I will keep changing my roles in life, because that is what the life should be like. Otherwise it will become very boring. So you will not be at one position for your whole life, right? So when you start working, you will continue to grow in your job prospects also. You will not say, no, that I want to be like this only. I like being this only. I don't want to grow. So continuously, when you have the desire to grow, when you want to take those initiatives, when you want to do those things, then life will be more interesting. The moment you start thinking that, no, I'm not worth it, I have nothing to achieve in life, and I have nothing left to learn, life will stop. So keep learning, keep growing. Thank you.
We have time.
Good evening. So Bihar is a very beautiful place. If you guys have thought of it to be like what it is shown in news, it is not. I've been there. I've lived in Bihar for 15 days. Sitamadi. Have you known of, heard of it? So I shot there for this particular film for 15 days. And people were really nice. People were like really, really humble there. And I saw the biggest tree of my life. It was a humongous banyan tree. Humongous is the word. The expanse was probably as big as this hall. Why we did not was, probably we were ahead of time that time. Independent cinema was still not considered a profitable venture. So it was an independent film. It was directed by one of the best cinematographers in the country. He's a 3-time National Award winner. And it was his debut film as a director, my debut film as an actor. It was just way ahead of its time. And then again, you know, as I say, that when you have a dialogue and you can mend things, you can continue to grow. But there were certain people who did not have that ability to understand that time. So it was because of those two people, I can say that, you know, because of their own egos, it did not get through. But hopefully, I'm still on it. It's been 10 years. Done. The girls didn't participate. Thank you so much. Great talking to you guys. All the best. But be ready to, you know, to do hard work. Otherwise, it's very, very important to do that. Thank you so much. Great talking to you guys. All the best. Thank you.